Yo,
Hey, are
what's
we
up,
not pausing?
guys? It's Jolly here, and I was just watching two of my buddies play, and we're gonna go over the game. I got both of them on Skype, so I got Timmy and Ash. Say hi.
Yo, what's up?
Hi.
Timmy2K here.
All right, so these guys just
Gay.
you're a fucking joke. These guys just played a game on Savannah, Isis versus Hades, and we're just gonna kind of go through it, and I'm gonna kind of
Let's
help
get
both
it.
of them out and just point shit out. So, all right, we'll get into it. So let's unpause the
Fucking
rec.
do it.
Let's get going. All right, so wonderful archaic age, super boring. We can't watch anything. We just watch each you guys kill some rhinos.
Yeah. From whose perspective should we watch this? Should we just start watching our own and then
I'll
just go from
just
there?
I'll just flick between both.
Direct.
Okay.
In a direct.
Yeah. It's pretty simple. Alright,
Press
Ash, you gotta
button.
get that scout going way quicker.
Lege.
Just try speed up those starts. Like, even if
Etimus.
you spend like 10 minutes a day
Etimus.
just doing the first 2 minutes of a build order, just to like
Etimus.
make sure all of that stuff gets quicker.
Prostagma.
Right, I'm just gonna look at you guys as
In
scouting.
wedge.
I would have sent my Pharaoh out, Tim.
Okay,
Yeah,
to where
just
that second TC is.
Go that way and then go up and you'll probably find a forest and then go around it and then just come back in.
Yeah, I think that's where the zebra patch, my second
Yeah.
hunt, ended up being. I scouted that way late.
Great.
This priest going to the side now, I
Not
wouldn't go to the side. I would
that
go
far.
forward.
Enito.
Okay, so cut
Oh,
out
you
more
are
to the
going
middle at
forward.
this point.
Enito.
Yeah, go towards the middle more. Like, anything up that way. I mean, you just missed that gold mine and relic. That's pretty lame. But,
That's shitty.
Enito.
yeah, I would have. That's why I normally build my obelisk slightly closer to the edge, just so
Enito.
I make sure I cover a little more distance.
In a direct.
Okay.
Alright, Ash, let's look at your scouting. Okay, the loop around the base is good to start with. I mean, Greek scouting isn't too hard. You've got a permanent
Etimus.
scout. You don't need to think about it too much.
Lege.
It's looking all
Etimus.
good.
Greek scout OP.
Prostagma. Etimi.
What about storehouse placement where the wood choppers are? Probably should have two of the wood choppers on the other side of that storehouse.
I think your Rick's playing a lot faster than mine.
Greg.
Ah, damn it. Probably because I'm host. That always fucks it up.
Yeah, yeah. Mine's
Enito.
playing pretty slow. That's all
Etimus.
good. I'll catch up. I'll just jam some play fasts every now and then.
Prostagma.
Man, I had a god-awful start to my build order.
Ash, you see how the two villages
Prostagma.
on Rhino are super low?
Lege.
Um,
Prostagma.
before you
Prostagma.
killed that second rhino, I would have sent them to gold and
Etimus.
put two gold villages over, just to have healthy
Prostagma.
villages there. Yeah, you want to make your
Etimus.
micro a little bit
Lege.
better in the beginning so
Lege.
they don't get that low, but if they do, just because, you know, sometimes shit happens, switch them over. Because you don't want the rhino to
Prostagma.
fucking, go balls deep on you. It'll suck. Like,
Etimus.
losing a villager at the start is just it's a stupid
Enito.
disadvantage you put yourself at.
Yeah, another cool trick is you could probably garrison in that tower too if you're getting attacked by that rhino, and then
Enito.
ungarrison him just to
Yeah.
save that villager, save his health.
Damn, dude, you had gazelle scouted anyway, even if you didn't see those zebra. You could have used those gazelle to split your hunt. So, yeah, magic number,
Enito.
like 1350, 1300.
Great.
Like, you
Okay.
need that much food. If you got less than
Enito.
that, then just split your hunt.
In
Yeah,
wedge.
so you're
In
scouting with
wedge.
your Pharaoh now. If you'd done proper scouting earlier,
In a
you were only missing out on empowerment
direct.
on like three or four villages. But now, because your
Right.
Pharaoh's
In
away,
wedge.
you've got 11
In
villages
wedge.
that are all
In
dropping and
wedge.
not being empowered. So
Great.
that's why you want to get
Right.
it done early.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, so if I'm gonna
Prostagma.
Pharaoh scout, get it over
Etimus.
quick while you have
Lege.
less villagers.
Yeah.
Etimus.
Makes
Prostagma.
sense. Yeah, I think I just now found my zebra.
Etimus. Vulome. Etimi.
Overall strategy-wise, Ash, I don't like 2TCing here.
Etimi.
You know all the gold mines are forward and open. Prostagma. You might as well just go 1 TC Etimus. Athena with full Hippocon.
Prostagma.
I'll show you how to play it after this. I'll play after this and go Hades versus Isis on Savannah, Prostagma. And I'll show you what I do.
Oh, okay.
If you are 2TCing, you need to be up so much quicker, and you need to get the TC up, and you need to get army out faster. Because basically, you got a free Migdol. Watch the more 2TC wrecks, especially watch the Mister, even if he does it with Zeus or something. The build order is still the same, because it's Greek. Yeah. You want to be upping like 5 minutes at the latest, getting that second town center going, and you just need to get army out faster. Ghost Lake is someone else you can watch. He plays Poseidon. The guy literally all he does is he lives for 2 town center. So watch him and how he manages his eco. Because the thing is if you up this late and 2 town center on a map where a town center secures you no resources, the Isis player can actually gold drain you. And fortunately Tim didn't do that, but if he had like AE'd your base and fought and then had sent a chariot to your second gold mine, you would have lost the game at like 11 minutes just because you had no gold mine. You wouldn't have got to heroic, you wouldn't have been even able to make another Hippocon.
Damn, that's a good idea.
Yeah. I was sitting there watching that the whole game.
Oh, dude.
I was like, god damn,
that was painful.
You're just gonna let him mine 6k gold for free when you've got complete advantage.
Dude, I was like, how is he producing all of these?
Yeah. Yeah, so this up's just super, super, super slow. Just nothing good's gonna come from it on a one gold mine map. Like if it was Watering Hole and you're just going for like an all out boom, then I'll let you away with this, but you don't need to be up this late.
I think part of the problem was he didn't split his hunt up at all. Once he ran out of those rhinos, he had to walk all the way to those zebras to get that last 40 food or whatever it was.
Yeah, that too. But you got berries in your base and you already had a granary standing right by him, so just use it. Yeah, uptimes are really, really key the higher level you go. It's like Ash, you've played enough League of Legends. Like the best way I can put it is like you're just giving away first blood in lane by not upping on time. And then they come back to lane at like 4 minutes with a BF sword and you're Vayne playing into Graves and you just kinda wanna kill yourself. Not upping on time is pretty much doing that.
You just killed my boner right there with that League of Legends talk, Jack.
It's okay, man. You gotta play it. It's so good. Okay, so Ash, when you 2 town center, because you're up so late, it's okay, but like, you need to be making those stables as soon as you've got the wood to make them. Like, I'm watching you right now, and you're sitting on 300 resources of each, and you're just making your stables in 7 minutes. Like, a good Isis player on 1 town center is going to be up at 7:30. And if you've got no army on his gold mine at 7:30, he gets a free gold mine. So as soon as you start making that town center, and as soon as you get the wood to make stables, they've got to go up. And, Tim, you know how Fox was saying to put more vills on this gold mine for the prosperity?
Yes.
That's fine. If he told you to do that, I don't disagree with it. But what you need to do is, because you've put way more villages on gold, you need to move more off gold afterwards. So, like, when you got to heroic age, you're going to see here that you only switch a couple to wood, and you still leave heaps on gold, and you stockpile, like, 1k plus gold or something, and it's just so unnecessary. So if you do this bigger prosperity, you only need 10 villages max on gold afterwards. The rest need to go to wood.
Okay. So basically just cut it in half and send it to wood since I wasn't accruing any during that time. I need to play a little bit of catch up.
So you sent like 8 villages to go make the Migdol. Now I think your Migdol placement was... you're pushing it. Is all I'm going to say.
Should it be more in front of the gold mine? I wanted to kind of hit two birds with one stone and cover that TC.
Look where your close gold mine is. If you can put the Migdol in between the tower and the gold mine, and it's protected by a tower. Like you're lucky that Ash has no units. At 8:30 in the game, Ash should have like 6 or 7 Hippocon, both as heroes, and you would never be able to get this Migdol up.
Okay.
So like... I mean,
so maybe a little bit too gutsy then.
Like, if you know he's got this much army, then do it. But I don't think you knew.
No, I had no idea. Yeah. I didn't scout any of his base whatsoever. Yeah.
So what you can do is your Sphinx, if you just send him running around and have him kind of chasing around, you know exactly how much army he's got. And even versus like 1750 players, they will follow your Sphinx too hard and you'll get a free Magdala. But at least you know where his army is and how much army he has.
Okay.
Otherwise, your Magdala just had to go up by that tower in the really close gold mine.
Okay.
Yeah, and so right now you've got 800 food.
You need to.
You got 7 on wood. All those gold villages at home, if you put them all to wood now, you do not need to add to wood for the rest of the game.
Okay.
Yeah, just chuck them all.
That'll be enough.
Yeah, that'll be enough. That's 15. Get hand axe, and then you're free on wood production. And then at 9 minutes in the game, you've got all the gold, all the wood villages you need. You can just add to food. And then you'll just get, like, such a good economy. Because food's your most important resource before 15 minutes. And then, Ash, sort of your biggest mistakes start coming up now. You see his army... I'm just playing fast a little bit. So I'm at 10 minutes, and right now you need to put your sentinels down and you need the tower up. Because you know he's going to push your base, and you don't really want to fight it, so you can run your army around while you have 4 towers, 4 sentinels, and a town center all dealing damage and trying to avoid losing army. If you don't have those upgrades and you run away with your army, which you have to, otherwise it dies, then... you're still dealing damage to his army when he's trying to kill your base. If you don't have those upgrades, then like no damage gets done to his army and he takes your base for free. So right now the sentinels in the tower need to be upgraded.
Especially before I eclipse, he's not going to be able to sentinel.
Yeah.
With the other god powers being banned at that time.
And if you're turtling in your base, Tox are quite a good unit as well. If you're playing aggressive and out and open, Tox aren't great, but if you're sitting in your base, Tox sitting in choke points are quite strong. But don't make them early, like start making them like 9:30 to 10 minutes. And so the AE goes down and you just need to get the fuck out.
Yeah, he's still... okay. Where the Hippocon are fighting his ancestor, should he be fighting that and just let my siege ramps take everything down? Because he's
gonna
lose a lot of
units. He's got 900 wood stockpiled. Just let him kill your stables, run your army away, keep it alive, and build 4 or 5 stables right now with your wood villages at the back of your base. Because basically he's just like cutting production, which is smart. When you push, you want to cut this production. And also, if you had managed your eco properly, you would be upping heroic already. Like, you've got the food, you just needed the gold. And if you had kept your army alive, you could have gone heroic. And if you had sentinels and towers, this push wouldn't have done that much to you. And you probably could have won the game. Just by having those upgrades. Well, not win the game, but... you've given yourself the chance to win the game. The AE push hasn't broken you. You've survived it.
I remember you saying something, Jack, in a previous rec where you said if you have like a successful attack, you should auto-queue your troops to like the other side of the map because that's where you can expect all the villagers to be flushed out to.
Yep.
And
right
this
now
case,
in
that
this
would
push,
have totally been correct.
Exactly. Like
you've got the gold mine right on the other side of the map.
Yeah. Like, as soon as you cast that AE, your next chariot archer out of your Migdol just needs to go to the other side of the map and see what's there.
Yeah. Because his first gold mine is just completely overrun by me at this point.
Like, right now, like, Ash can go heroic. I don't know if he does straight away, but like, yeah, if you'd been on his gold mine now, even if he gets up to heroic, he's got nothing. He won't be able to make any units again. And, Tim, looking at your eco right now, this is like, you got too much on wood, all your food's gone idle. It's alright. But I would expect a second town center by now.
Okay.
But you've just stockpiled way too much gold. But at least you can make a ton of farms. And that's, most of this gold is coming from just not, like,
losing?
Not switching the gold earlier in the game.
Okay. So is that too much on wood then for, like, a chariot sea tramp
spam? Right now this is too much on wood. Like, okay. I'd let you away with 18 if you stopped there. I'd be like, okay, that's cool, just stop there. You ended up with 29 or something on wood. I'm like, Jesus Christ, boy.
What can I say? I love my wood, son.
Strive to make your farm placements better.
Okay.
Yeah. Just
both of us?
Yeah, all of you. Yeah, they're all trash. Alright, so at this point in the game at 13 minutes, you're pushing his base. You need to decide, am I going to keep pushing or am I going to boom? They're your only two options. There's no other option. The third option is to lose, and I'm not teaching you to lose. So,
yes, Dad.
Yeah, so like, you decide to keep pushing. If you keep pushing, you need to back up where you're pushing with production. So you need to go make a McDonald now. You've got like 2,000 gold. Take your fucking gold mine and your pharaoh into his base and build McDonald's in there.
Like by where his TC is and his first gold mine? Like that close?
Where you're pushing right now.
Okay.
Just go build a McDonald's there. How's he gonna stop you making it? As soon as it up, he's fucked. He'll never get that town center again.
Okay.
If you're not gonna keep pushing, then you need to be taking town centers. And you make elephants for way too long. You only need two or three. They're just tanks. Early game. Like, your eco can never, like... your eco can never support allies until you have, like, 40 on farms. And that's, like... 25 minutes mythic.
Should I have went to barracks units to deal with those cavalry, or should I just mass chariots?
Mass chariots with McDowell's, because you're so far ahead, and you got so many more units, and you can take Helder's building so quickly right now. Like, this is when chariots are super strong, because they're cheap and they're fast, and they deal ranged damage.
Mm-hmm.
So when you're ahead like this, like, you're just wrecking his Hippocon. But yeah, right now, like, you need to, if you had stopped elephants earlier, you'd have been able to get your town centers up, and, stop going onto wood, and then add one TC to gold, and one make farms, and you would have
Holy shit, I have 26 on wood at this time, man. 27.
Yeah. It's not great. Alright, so at this point in the game, at like 14 minutes, the only way I could describe what you're doing is like, okay, if you had a pizza, and imagine it's like... Like a fucking big pizza. This is like a 15-inch like diameter pizza or something.
Ooh, yes.
Yeah? And you take your first bite, and then you take your second bite exactly where the first one was, but further to the center. And then you take your third bite to the center until the pizza's halfway wrapped around your head and you have all the fucking sauce over your face and on the floor because you kept biting in the same fucking location. This is what you're doing to his base right now. Look at it. His base is a pizza and you're just eating chunks through the middle. You're trying to cut this pizza in half with your mouth. Stop.
Yes.
Eat the fucking sides of it, man. Come on. Stop making a mess of your pizza. Yeah, you needed to just send...
A pizza metaphor.
Oh, dude, seriously, man. I was getting so wound up watching this. You just need to, like, switch onto the front of his base where his temple is, just kill that, and then go around, yeah? Because basically you're just running the gauntlet right now, and it's too hard to push anything.
Okay.
Into you. Yeah.
So temple, those houses, and stable over on that side.
Ideally
for the
gold
TC.
Mine, but yeah, you know what I mean? Like, when you get into this, like, push scenario, you're overextending the push. Just go back, take what you can. Because, like, yeah, if you run into the middle of his base, he's got all of his production there, you've got no production there, he can easily flank you, etc., etc. Just clear out the easy stuff that you can.
Okay, makes sense. What about him trying to reclaim that TC? What do you feel about that? Like, with all of my units fucking surrounding it.
Well, if you had a McDole there, like, on his gold mine, and then pushed where his temple is, like, yeah, he's never gonna take the town center back.
Okay.
Yeah.
What time are you guys at?
I'm at, 1550.
Okay.
Yeah. So you finally pick up your second town center, which is good to see. And you've got so many resources. Spend those resources, man. And you got 35 on wood.
Fucking A, dude. What should I be focusing my resources on primarily at this point?
Getting town centers, getting economy ups, just spending them, making farms. Like, you're just striving to get, like, build them as quick as you can right now. Because, like, your units cost wood and gold. So it's no real harm on your economy. That's why this is so strong.
Okay.
And you've got all the wood you need with, like, 15, 16 villages and wood. So then everything else you can just pump into eco, but you've still got massive, like, military pressure. Basically, everything that's happening right now is fed off your AE. Like, this is just snowballing all off the AE pressure.
Okay.
Yeah.
Dude, I can't believe I didn't do a little bit more searching around for, like, resources around his
base.
But
the great thing you're doing is you've used the AE advantage, you know his production's less than yours, and he's got less army, so you'll keep, you keep fighting, which is really, really good. So, that's something you're doing superbly well.
Did I hurt his economy enough, though? I don't know how many villagers I dropped. But
it doesn't matter how much you
hurt
his economy, he can't do anything to stop you, because, like, he's got lots of resources, but he's got no population to do anything with it.
Okay.
Yeah. And so, like, if you'd had your Migdol and a monument up there now, that curse would have never have happened. And if you'd been on his gold mine, yeah.
Prostagma. Prostagma.
Yeah, I was a little bit worried here at this point at 1735 that my attack was losing steam after that curse.
Yeah, at this point in the game, like, you should be mythic with three town centers.
Oh, Jesus. Dude, I have 37 on wood.
Yeah, that's a big problem.
Whenever I grab a new TC, I'm just like, oh, okay, I don't see any gold nearby, I'll just put them on wood.
Yeah, no, you need to get to those gold mines and secure the map a bit more. And I want to see those markets up a lot earlier. Yeah. Even if you're not making trade, those, just get the market up and ready.
Okay.
Yeah.
...1807, I gloriously spot his second gold.
Yeah.
While it has 130 left, 100 gold left in it.
Yeah, I've just whacked it in play fast to finish this out.
Dear God. So that would have been a knockout blow so much earlier if I would have just checked out to see where he was getting his gold from, his second gold.
Yeah, for sure.
The scouting, I felt like I had total tunnel vision the whole game.
Yeah. Alright, sweet. Okay, so main points. We'll go over Ash first. Main point number one. You need to up on time. Main point number two, if you two town center, you need army faster. And then third point, fortify base for AE. And then four, you need to, like, have a sub 13 minute heroic. They're your main points, and everything else, like, will become easier for that. So basically, everything that's going wrong for you right now is a result of your macro. So you just need to improve your macro and your economy, and then everything will go so much smoother. Right, Tim, your main stuff. You need to... point number one. You need to up on time. Remembering the 1350 food.
Okay.
Yeah. Two, Migdol placement. Just think about his army. Number three, are you, so you need to, so when pushing, make sure you have him in his base. So that means sending, that chariot off to the side to, like, his gold mines to make sure he's not gathering where you don't know about.
Okay.
Then number four, you need to decide, am I raiding, booming, or carrying on pushing? And if you do the raiding booming, you need to grab your town centers and run around with chariots. And if you're pushing, you need to get your MGDOLs up forward where you want to push.
Okay.
You can't
so
send
like establish production on
yeah.
like ground that I've taken.
Yeah, exactly.
Okay.
And then five post 12 men eco management.
Oh,
that
yes.
will come with a little bit more. All right. Okay, we'll call the video quits here. So cheers for watching, guys, and do some more another time.